everyone, and welcome to Fatima's Art Show. Today, I'm doing something a bit different. I'm going to be talking about decluttering and tidying your house. Now, the reason why I thought it would be a good idea to do this episode is because I'm currently in the process of decluttering my house and throwing away all the things I don't need, especially in my artist studio. So I'm going to sort of talk about how to tidy your artist studio, because I generally talk about art-based things, but also you can use these tips to tidy around your whole home. So you can use these tips to tidy anywhere in any room in your house. So I hope this helps everybody, because I feel like it really has helped me. The first tip is, if you have anything you don't want, throw it away. Now, you might think that's not really a tip. I mean, I don't really need to know that. I mean, that's obvious. But actually, sometimes we hold on to things that we actually don't need. We just hold on to them. Especially if you're a creative person, you're creative minded, you look at things that might be actually rubbish or like anything. And you might think, oh, I can do something with that. I can make this and I can make that and I can do something with that. And yes, you probably can. And I've done episodes where I've used very simple things that you might throw away and made them into something. And that is possible. The best way I solved this was that if it's something that I can get any time, then I shouldn't hold on to it. I shouldn't keep it in my artist studio. And things like cardboard boxes. I know that if I'm working on a project and I need a cardboard box, I can go to the supermarket. I can go to my local supermarket and tell them, do you have any cardboard boxes? And I'm sure they'll be happy to give me some. So really, I don't need to hold on to this box. I can throw it away and it will save so much space. The other thing that I realize that I do a lot is that I keep tubes of paint that have dried out. So here I've got some tubes of paint that had just dried out, and I didn't even know that I couldn't use them. I had loads of them in my drawer, and then when I looked through my drawer and I opened it up, and I was like quite surprised. I was like, wait a minute, there's a lot of these that are no use to me, but I've just held on to them for some reason. I don't know why. So that was one thing that kind of like made me think, okay, get rid of those. Now, that also, you can use that tip for other things, things that have expired in your kitchen, anything around the house that you don't really need. Now, there are things that you might be thinking, but wait a minute, I've actually thrown this thing away, and then at a later date I thought, oh, I actually needed that. You know, or you've held on to it and at a later date you've actually used it. And it does happen, it happens to me. With those things, what you do, you get a box, for instance, and it's all about organizing. You get a box, for instance, I have a box that's labeled scrap fabric. So any fabrics that I have that I know I'm gonna need at a later date and I don't wanna throw them away, I feel like I will need them for other projects, I organize them in a box and I write scrap fabric. So if there are particular things that you need, for instance, like if you know you're doing a project that you're gonna need bottle tops, you basically put it in a box and label it and it'll be nicely organized, it'll be all in one place, and you could probably hold on to it. I mean, that's not to say that you fill up your whole artist studio's lots of boxes, but it's a nice sort of thing to do so that you're decluttered and you're tidy. Tip number two, finding time. I think that's one of the ones that a lot of people, when you tell them, when they say, oh, my house is messy, my room is messy, I didn't have time. Let's call it an excuse, because a lot of people say it. it's an excuse, basically, finding time. I think with things like that, you might have a job, you might have somewhere to go to. So what you need to do, you need to fit it in your schedule. So you need to somehow say, between this time and this time, I am just gonna be working on this section of the house, okay? So then afterwards, you can relax. At the same time, you can have a cup of coffee, watch TV after you've done this particular section of your house or your artist studio. Sometimes also with finding time, you might look at the whole house, or you might look at a particular room and you're going to be like, I'm never going to be able to tidy this. And I've felt this before. I'm never going to be able to tidy this space. But when you break it up into bite-sized chunks, so you do, for instance, if it's a house, you do each room each day. If it's a room, if it's an artist's room or any room, you do a particular section. So today I'm going to sort out my paint tubes and all the paints I want and don't want. Today I am going to work on all the different papers, fabrics or whatever, and I'm going to organize them, and I'm going to make sure that if there's any papers I don't want, I throw them away. Things like that. And then it gets a lot easier. It gets really easy to declutter and to tidy because you are finding the time. So tip number three, I asked one of my closest friends and sister, how do you keep your room so tidy? And she said to me that one of the tips, which I kind of, it's kind of stayed with me, is everything needs to have a place. And so as I kind of mentioned before, when you are tidying, you are also organizing, so that when you sometimes you go through stages where for instance you want to find a particular item, you're not rummaging through trying to find that little thing to use, or like, oh, I need those pair of scissors, oh, where are they, or I need to use that particular fabric paint or pen or anything really, and you're looking around, you're going crazy, you're looking around the whole house or the whole of the artist studio, wherever it is, and you're trying to work out where it is. So it eliminates all that, so you know, these are where my pens are, these are where my fabrics are, these are where my papers are, this is where my cards, this is where I keep my cards, this is where I keep my papers, and so you know where everything is. So as soon as you want it, as soon as you need it, it's right there in front of you. You don't need to go looking around, and it actually saves a lot of time. You might think it takes a lot of time to organize it, but it saves you a lot of time in the long run. So when you actually need it, it's there. So that's tip number three. Tip number four is sell things. So anything that you think might be worth value that you don't want to throw away and you know you don't need. So you might have three easels, but actually for the last year you've been using that one easel, or whatever it is, you might have just been using it for that whole year. You might just be using that one particular thing, but you might have three of that same item and you know it's worth money and you don't want to throw it away. Sell it. So there are lots of websites where you can sell things, such as eBay, Gumtree. There are particular different, depending what country you are as well, there's different websites that you can sell things you don't want. So you get money from the things that you've sold. And what I like to do is I reinvest it in my studio. So if I sell things that I don't want, I reinvest it. So I get things that I need to make a particular thing or work on a particular project. So I kind of reinvest it into my work. So that's a nice idea. Tip number five. You won't do it later. That's why I call tip number five. A lot of times you go through times where you kind of like, you just want to ignore that task you have, you want to distract yourself, and you say to yourself, I'll do it later, and guess what, later never comes, or it does come, but by the time it comes you have gotten way too much to do. So like dishes, for instance, you might have two dishes in the sink and you're gonna be like, I'll do that later, I don't need to do it now. And then what happens is, before you know it, the whole sink is full of dishes. So same thing goes with when you're working on a project, an artistic project, and you are working and you've got bits of paper, you've cut out lots of things, and you've got bits of paper, materials, and everything all over the place. And you're like, I'm gonna do that later. And then you work a bit more every day. You come into the space, you come into the artist studio, you work a little bit more on that project, and the room gets even more messier and even more messier. And especially with things like paints, particular paints like acrylic, if they are put on a carpet and you don't wash them instantly, they dry to the carpet and they're a really stubborn stain to get out. You almost impossible to get out. So there are things like that as well. So never say I will do it later. Do it now. Get it out the way. That's a really good tip. So I hope you have enjoyed this episode and I hope it helps you, because it has helped me. So I thought it would be fantastic to share it, as I said. And thank you for watching. You can follow me on Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook. Just search for Fatema's Art Show. And I'll see you next time.